So now what is that you are going to study in this particular chapter? So these are the points which are discussed, except that network layer performance is not there in your syllabus, but otherwise this is part of this chapter. So you are going to study about the different network layer services, the packet switching, IPv4 addresses, which are very important, because when you talk about host to host communication across the networks, then how are they identified? They are identified by what is called as the IP address, and V4 is the version 4 which you are going to discuss in this particular chapter. And also which are the techniques for forwarding the IP packets. These are the contents of this particular chapter. So let's discuss one by one. So as I said, this particular chapter is important because network layer takes care of host-to-host communication. So you will understand what are the different services as the objective one. You are going to understand the services which are provided by the network layer. And what are the different techniques which are adopted for providing these type of services, mainly on packetization, forwarding and routing, which are the different techniques which are adopted for forwarding, routing the packets from host to host. Then we are also talking about the address, which are very important when you talk about network layer. There is a specific address with which the packet is identified, that is the IP address, and what is the format which is used for representing the IP address. Then you are also talking about, in the fourth section of this particular chapter, you are also going to discuss about, in continuation with the previous objective, you are going to talk about the different types of addressing, the classful, classless addressing, and also the important protocol like dynamic host configuration protocol, and also the other technique which is called as network address translation technique, NAT. And also the next objective is to find out which are the different types of techniques which are used for forwarding an IP packet. These are the objectives of this particular chapter. So as we know that network layer is an important layer in the TCP/IP model because it takes care of host-to-host communication. So to understand the importance of the network layer, in fact, the same example was studied when you took up the data link layer services, so which takes care of hop-to-hop communication. The same example is taken here with the addition of a network layer to understand the importance of network layer. So let's go to this diagram. So this particular diagram talks about the communication which happens at the network layer. The same example as we have seen in the data link layer. This is the same example where, you know, the Alice machine is the source machine, and you have a machine as a source machine, as the Alice machine in one of the network, and the destination machine is called as the Bob machine, which is somewhere in some other network. So to form a network, you require connecting devices. The Alice machine is not only the machine which is present in that network, it is connected to n number of host machines which are connected using a link layer switch. Then how are these packets which is coming from the Alice machine reaching the destination point, which is the Bob machine, which is in some other network? So the three important layers which have to be considered to understand the services of network layer are the physical, data link, and network layer. And why data link? Because you have so many intermediate devices which the packet has to move across to reach the destination point, which is somewhere else in some part of the network. Hence, data link layer is also important and network layer is also important. Network layer is because you're talking about the transfer or the routing of packets across the networks between two different networks which are situated at somewhere else. We don't know, right? So now in this example, you are talking about the flow of packets from the source machine, which is the Alice machine, to a destination machine, which is the Bob machine. So at the Alice machine, you have to have three important layer: network, data link, physical layer. And what is the path or the route which is actually defined for this flow of packet is that from the Alice machine network, from the switch, it goes to R2, from R2 to R4, from R4, it goes to the switched WAN, from switched WAN, it goes to R5, from R5, it goes to R7, from R7 is delivered to the switch, link layer switch, which is connected to the Bob machine network. And finally, it is the job of the switch to forward the packet to the Bob machine. So this is how a packet is flowing because of the presence of a network layer from a machine which is at some network, which is the Alice machine, to a destination machine, which is the Bob machine, which is in some other network. So the connecting devices play a very important role, and especially when you are connecting the networks, the important connecting devices which is used is called as a router. So the router plays a very important and the significant role in forwarding the packets from one network to another network. Okay, and network layer is important here in this situation because it takes care of host machine packet to destination machine, which is in some other network. So this is how it is activated at the Alice machine end or the network end. You have the importance of the source machine is your Alice machine. That information is passed on to the network layer. So the network layer encapsulates and forms it as a packet with all the header and information added to it. And that packet is called as a datagram. The datagram moves down the layer through the physical layer. It reaches R2. In R2, whenever there is a router, you have two important receiving end as well as the transmitting end. At the first end, it receives the datagram from the Alice machine network, and then it decapsulates it, sends it to the data link layer, and receives at the network layer of the router. Then again, encapsulation happens, and it follows down the line, data link, physical layer, and it reaches the R4. So you have two communication there, one at the receiving end, and then the other one at the transmitting end at the router. Whereas at the different source machine and the destination point, only one set of layers are used, network layer, a data link layer, and physical layer. But in the router, it has to receive the packet from one network and transfer it to the another network. And hence you have two network data link physical layer and another one network data link physical layer. There are two sets of layers which are used because it has to receive the packet from one network and deliver the packet to another network. That is why you have two sets of layers functioning at the router end. Whereas at the source machine and the destination machine, you have only either decapsulation or encapsulation happening, which is sending and receiving the packet, which is the source machine and the destination machine. So this particular example tells you how a packet moves. So after R2, it goes to R4. R4 does the same operation, receives it, and it decapsulates it, finds out, sends it to data link layer, and at the network layer, it again forms a packet datagram, and then sends it to another part of the network, which is received by R5, similarly R7, till it reaches the destination link layer switch, where the link layer switch sends it to the Bob machine. This is the significance of the network layer or the communication which happens at the network layer from a source host to destination host, which are situated at different networks. So this is an example which tells you the importance or significance of a network layer. Then coming to the services of the network layer. Network layer, what it has to do, first of all, it has to receive information from the upper layer. Which is the upper layer to the network layer? It is a transport layer. It receives an information from the transport layer, and the first job is to convert it into a packet. So the first function of a network layer is what is called as packetization. That means it has to convert the information received from the upper layer, encapsulate it with all the header information, and convert it into a suitable format, which is called as a packet. And that packet is referred at the network layer or called at the network layer as a datagram. So the first service which has to be offered by the network layer is what is called as packetization. Or the first duty of the network layer is what is called as packetization. At the source end, it encapsulates the information, payload or information at the network layer. And then at the receiving end, it decapsulates so that from the network layer, it removes the information what is required for network layer and sends the other information to the top layer, which is the transport layer. So it forms what is called as encapsulation and decapsulation, for which the first duty of the network layer is forming a packet. and this packet is referred as the datagram at the network layer. So what is the job? First one is to create an information into a acceptable format, which is called as packetization. So that packetization is the first function of the network layer, and the packet which is created will be delivered from the source machine to the destination machine without changing the contents or the payload. The second important duty which the network layer has to perform is routing and forward. So other than packetization, first duty is to receive the information, convert it into a datagram or a packet. At the destination point, decapsulate it and send the information to the upper layer. So this is the first function, which is called as packetizing or packetization. So the second duty is to form the to be performed by the network layer is routing and forwarding. So what is routing? So the if the packet arrive at the router, it has to find out which is the optimal path or the shortest path, which is more convenient for the packet to be delivered to the destination point at with the short interval of time. That is what is called as optimal route. So it has to decide which is the optimal route and select that appropriate route. That is what is called as routing, which is done using the routing protocols, which you are going to discuss later on. So the with the help of routing protocols, it finds out which is the optimal route to forward the packet. Then what is forwarding? So forwarding to when a particular packet arrives at the router. So once it knows that this is the optimal path, how does it understand this is the optimal path? There will be a what is called as a routing table, which is a decision table created at the router. So it understands that it has come to the router at this through this particular port or the interface, and the outgoing port or the interface is this particular port number or the interface number. So once the packet arrives at the router using one of the interfaces or the port, it knows that it has to be forwarded through another port, which is an outgoing port. Which port it is? It is decided using the decision table or the routing table. So there are two important things other than the packetization, which the network layer has to do. One is called as the routing. The other one is forwarding. Routing is nothing but the routing of packets using the optimal path or optimal route, which is being fixed using the routing part. Protocols. The forwarding is nothing but once the packet arrives at the input port or the interface of a router, it should be put to the next network, forwarded to the next immediate destination point using a decision table or the routing table. So these are the two important functions of routing and forwarding other than packetization or datagram formation. So if it has to forward the packet, then you require a forwarding table or a decision making table or the routing table. So the contents of the general contents of a forwarding table will have a forwarding value and the output interface. So by understanding the configuration, the routing table is dynamically built, the constructed or built. So here it requires the address through which the forwarding value is nothing but these are the entries in the table which tells to which port the packet is arriving, and from when the packet has arrived to this particular port, through which port it has to be sent. So there is always a entry made based on the address of the packet. So A, if it the output interface is 1, if it is B, the output interface will be 2. So send the packet out of interface 2. C may be similar to B. That's just an added one. So C may be similar to B. So what are the two values which are required for general forwarding table? Is this is just a general forwarding table. You require a forwarding value in terms of the address. You should understand through which port it has to go out. That is the output interface or the output port. So if at all a packet arrives with the forwarding value as B, then the output interface for that particular packet is 2 only and not other ports which are indicated in the routing table or the decision table. So forwarding table or the decision table helps the packet to be forwarded, which arrives at the input port through which port it has to go out, or the through which interface it has to go out. So this value is what is called as the forwarding value, and the output interface indicates through which it has to be dispatched, forwarded to the next immediate destination point. This is how a forwarding table looks like, a general forwarding table. And the forwarding process is nothing but looking at the address, it understands that it has arrived at port one, and it has to be, if it has to go out, dispatch, it has to go out of the router, it has to go out through only port number two. So send the packet out of interface two is what is the action which takes place under the forwarding process. You will understand this better when you actually construct the forwarding table. So the three important services which a router has to do at the network layer is, one is packetization, second one is forwarding and routing. Routing and forwarding. Packetization is nothing but converting the information received from the upper layer, encapsulating it with header information, and creating a packet which is called as a datagram. The routing is nothing but, so which is the selection of an optimal route or a path to deliver the packet to the next destination. Forwarding is when a packet arrives at one of the input port or the interface of the router. So it has to go out through the output interface. Which output interface or which output port is designated for that particular packet using a forwarding table or the decision table. And that process is called as forwarding process. Using this process, the forwarding action happens at the router. So you have three important functions. One is packetization. Second one is routing. Third one is forwarding. So forward, you require a forwarding table or the decision making table. Other services which are expected, but we need not have to happen at the network layer are, suppose it is expected that network layer, other services which is expected out of any layer is error control. But error control, network layer itself in the internet cannot provide error control because it offers best effort services. If you take IP as a protocol, it offers best effort services. Then how does the error control is happening in the network layer? To certain extent, error control is happening at the network layer using one of the adjunct or the auxiliary protocol called as ICMP, Internet Control Management Protocol or Message Protocol. So ICMP is, through ICMP, it performs to a certain extent error control. Next one is flow control. Flow control is what? A source generates the packet, destination has to receive the packet, or the receiver has to receive the packet. The speed at which the packets are generated, the source end, may not be at the receiver the same speed. At the same speed, the receiver may not be functioning to receive the packet. In the sense, the receiver may not have the capacity to receive as many packets as the source generates. So it has, the actual protocol has to understand the capacity of the receiver or the storage capacity or the temporary buffer space at the receiving end, and then only pump in the packets. So if at all, if it gets an acknowledgement that I am ready to accept the packets, then only the sender or the source can send the packets. This is what is called as flow control, which is managed by many number of protocols, but network alone cannot manage the flow control. But this flow control at the network layer is managed by the upper layer protocols. So network layer alone cannot do the operation of flow control. That means it depends, it is leaving the job of flow control to the upper layer protocols. Next, congestion. What is congestion? Congestion is if a datagram is pumped in or the packets are sent by the source beyond the capacity of the channel or the routers or the network capacity, then there is a tendency for a congestion to happen. Because of congestion, the datagrams may be lost, may be dropped, and there should be some error control mechanisms to control this congestion. Again, network layer by itself will not take care of congestion control. It depends on the upper layers to take care of congestion control by resending the packets or retransmission of packets. So network layer, of course, is also expected to provide quality of service. Initially, quality of service was not a concern of the internet, but because multimedia applications are supported for internet Then quality of service is also a criteria which the network layer has to meet, and network layer again depends on higher layer protocols for providing quality of service. So error control, to certain extent, ICMP manages. Flow control, network layer cannot provide, but upper layer protocols will provide. Congestion control, again, it is supported by upper layer protocols. Quality of service is again supported by higher layer protocols. Security is a concern which has to be addressed by the network layer. Of late, it is supported by IP security, which takes care of security of or safeguarding the security of information.